Louis Sachar was born in March 20 of 1954 in East Middle, New York. He lived there until he was in third grade. When he was 9 years old, his family decided to move to Tustin, California. As a young boy, he remembers playing in the orange groves of Tustin and having orange fights with his friends. During his high school years, he began to read books written by J.D. Salinger and Kurt Vonnegut, who became his inspiration and influenced him to develop a passion for literature. After high school, he attended Antioch College in Ohio, but after his father's death, he decided to return to California to be with his mother. In California, he attended the University of California at Berkeley, where he majored in economics. One day, as he walked the campus, he saw an elementary school girl handing out flyers that said, "Help, we need teacher aides at our school. Earn 3 units of credit." He thought it was a good deal, so he decided to accept the offer and spend the semester at Hillside Elementary. Besides helping out in the classroom, Mr. Sachar also became the cafeteria supervisor, or Louis the yard teacher, as the kids called him. For Mr. Sachar, this course became his favorite college class and a life-changing experience. After graduating from college and inspired by his experience at Hillside Elementary, he wrote his first book, Sideways Stories from Wayside School. It was published in 1978. After graduating from the University of California, Mr. Lewis decided to apply for law school. He graduated in 1980 and began to do part-time legal work as he continued to write children's books. In 1985, he married Carla, and in 1987, their daughter Sherry was born. It was also in this same year that Sachar published his second book, There's a Boy in the Girl's Bathroom. After 8 years of practicing law, in 1989, Sachar decided to end his career as a lawyer and devote to write children literature completely. In 1991, Mr. Sachar and his family moved from San Francisco to Austin, Texas. Cool ocean breezes and fog were replaced with an incessant hot, dry heat. It was this setting that inspired him to create Camp Green, the memorable setting of Hope's book that garnered him the Newbery Medal and the National Book Award for Young People's Literature. Louis Sachar writes fiction novels for elementary school students with interesting, fun, catching plots and characters. Some of his works include the novel Hopes, which has sold over 8 million copies worldwide and has been made into a motion picture of the same name by Disney. He also writes book series. Some of them are Marvin Redpost and Sideways Stories from Wayside School. Unlike many of his colleagues, Mr. Sachar is a solitary writer. He never shares his stories with anyone, not even his wife and daughter, until he's ready to submit them to his editor. He says this helps him stay motivated. The only ones allowed in his office when he's writing are his dogs Lucky and Tippy. Louis Sachar obtains most of his inspiration from his surroundings. The Wayside School series was inspired by his experience as a teacher aide in college. The setting of the novel Holes was inspired by the dry, warm climate of Austin, Texas. His wife Carla was a counselor in elementary school when he first met her, and was the inspiration for the counselor in his second book, There's a Boy in the Girl's Bathroom. Some of his works include Pig City, which is about a secret club called Pig City where members must reveal something embarrassing to the other members as insurance. Before long, everything is out of control. Pig City has a rival, the secrets are exposed, and Laura, one of the story's characters, sort of loses her hair. His popular Sideways Stories from Wayside School is about a school that was supposed to be 30 classrooms, one story high. but by mistake, it was built straight up 30 stories, and that's not fun at all. This book holds is about Stanley Yelnat, who is sent to Camp Green Lake Juvenile Correction Facility for a crime he did not commit. He has to dig a hole per day in the baking Texas heat, looking for who knows what. Some of the prestigious awards Louis Sachar has won for his works and honors are the Newbery Medal in 1999, the National Book Award for Young People's Literature in 1998, the New York Times Book Review for Notable Children's Books of the Year, the School's Library Journal Best Book of the Year, the Bulletin Blue Ribbon Book, the Publisher's Weekly Best Book of the Year. Also, Liverpool City Read Title, and the Sheffield Book Award in the United Kingdom. Louis Sachar currently lives with his family in Austin, Texas, where he continues to write adventurous and exciting stories.